Good day, students. Welcome to RATS, Racing Against Time for Students in Pathology. Today, I am to start a new chapter, namely infectious diseases. But then, there are other subjects such as microbiology for it. Then, what can we expect in pathology? In PATH, we shall expect questions that have got morphological lesions, specific gross or microscopic features which are characteristic of that particular disease. Let us have that as a parameter and go into the chapter. So, the chapter for the day is this. Without much ado, I shall go to the first topic. What are we seeing on the screen? Obviously, you find that this is supposed to be a sin that I deserved that came to me from heaven or hell. And in another picture, I find that there is a crippling disability and it has made me stay in the outskirts rather than in the society. I hope you people can guess the diagnosis. Leprosy. Many a giant has dedicated his life to leprosy, and one such person was Hansen, such that it is called Hansen's disease otherwise. It is a topic of paramount importance, which is all shown in the enclosure, covering across a lot of subjects. Caused by Mycobacterium leprae. It is a bacilli. Bacilli in the sense it is rod-shaped, short and stout. Unlike the tubercle bacilli, which is slightly longer, curvilinear. It has got a cigar bundle-like appearance. In some places, as we shall see subsequently also, we find that it is in a kind of a bundle called a cigar bundle appearance. And some people describe it as a fish in a stream appearance, the parallelly swimming fish. It is acid fast, weakly alcohol fast, and cannot be grown in culture. That perhaps is the greatest disadvantage, owing to which we are not able to find a correct drug in the treatment of leprosy in time. There are two types of immunity, the cell-mediated and the humoral immunity in this. And this particular stain is showing a lot of lepra bacilli. This is a wonderful conceptual effort which I had picked up from the net and a diagram. There are two terms that we should remember. One is called the globi, which is masses of bacilli lying together. Look at this particular one, very diligently drawn. And the other one is the furcocele, though it is V, we call it as F. Furcocele, which are foamy macrophages. And these are the foamy macrophages that contain them. They are otherwise called the lepra cells also. Normally, you find that the lepra bacilli survives on the cooler parts of the body, such as the armpits, extremities, the nose, etc. Also, the nerve bundles are affected. And there are different types of lesions which we hope shall touch upon during this discussion. So this is a beautiful diagram. I would like you people to draw it in your examinations, showing the globi, the parallel arrangement of the cells and the cigar bundle appearance. And the second one is the furcocele or the foamy macrophage. It is more of a disease of immunity rather than infection by itself. What happens is there is a spectrum. Anybody who is affected by leprosy does not develop the same manifestation as another. In one end, I have got what is called as a tuberculoid leprosy, and at the other end, there is a lepromatous leprosy. And Here there is an increased amount of cell mediated immunity, whereas here there is an increased amount of antibody response. And they are corollarily opposite. For example, in leprometous leprosy, it is low towards the beginning, and in tuberculoid leprosy, the cell mediated immunity comes down. What is the clinical spectrum of leprosy? So you find that in one, for example, tuberculoid, there is an increased amount of immunity which progressively decreases. Whereas in all the others, in leprometous leprosy, skin lesions are more, bacilli are more, and the skin test is also positive. So please do remember both these schematic diagrams. As I mentioned earlier, one of the greatest disadvantages was it could not be grown in culture. However, Shepherd was one person who tried to culture lepra bacilli in the footpads of mice. And in fact, he was successful, but beyond that, we were not able to progress. And this creature is a 9-banded armadillo. Now look at the number of bands that you are finding on the back of it. It will be 9. It is an anteater or an armadillo, and it has got exactly the same behavior towards leprosy as the human beings, and it has been used in a great deal of research. This picture I have projected for a different reason. What are you seeing on the screen? What are you seeing on the screen? It is not just a lesion as such. I find that there is a sense of despondence or hopelessness in the patient. The patient not only is suffering from auto amputation of the digits, a saddle nose deformity, loss of the eyebrows, and an exposure keratitis, but beyond that, I could see there is a sense of hopelessness, despondence, and there have been social outcasts. So this is the weightage of this picture. I hope you people will carry it home. And loneliness, nowadays it has been compared with leprosy. Loneliness today is leprosy of the modern world. You know how painful it is to be lonely. Mother Teresa, a person who has dedicated herself. In fact, if at all there is one particular slide that I would like you people to remember, it will be this. How do you classify leprosy? So on exposure, you find that there can be patients with very high cell-mediated immunity and very poor cell-mediated immunity. And in some people, it can be midway. So these are the extremes. And according to that, we get the lesions. Before any particular type of leprosy develops, there is an intervening stage called indeterminate Hansen's or indeterminate lesion. It will just look like a dermatitis or an inflammation of the skin. Beyond that, we will not be able to make any diagnosis. And in some patients, we find that there can be a spontaneous resolution, but mostly it remains either as tuberculoid or leprometous. So in the classification, please remember the yellow and the blue, the tuberculoid and the leprometous. These are the two spectrums. And whenever there is a spectrum, midway there will be something, and that is called borderline. And borderline itself, if it is more towards tuberculoid, it is called borderline tuberculoid. If it is more towards leprometous, it is called borderline leprometous. And if it is right in the middle, we call it as borderline. So obviously, there will be fewer bacilli. Skin and nerve can be involved in this, whereas there will be many bacilli in leprometous leprosy. So there is a poorer prognosis in this, better prognosis in this. This particular classification, kindly do remember. And the only way of remembering is repetition. Repetition is the mother of knowledge. So exposure, depending on the immunity, there will be a tuberculoid stage or a leprometous stage, before which we have got and indeterminate Hansen's, non-specific inflammation. Between tuberculoid and lepromatous, there is a borderline which is again divided into borderline tuberculoid, borderline lepromatous, and borderline. And this is an electron micrographic picture that is showing the lepra bacilli, short and stout. One is the lepromatous leprosy. This is a histological picture, but then let us see the general features before that. It affects the cooler parts of the body. The epidermis is thinned out. Look at this particular one. There is a thinning out of the epidermis. There is a loss of the retae ridges. So the retae ridges are lost. And there is a clear zone. So here I find that there is a clear zone, which is called the Grenz zone. Grenz is an Austrian dermatologist. Or it is otherwise called the unknown band of Anna. Anna is again another person who has done a lot of research in this. Either the Grenz zone or the unknown band of Anna can be asked as MCQs. And here in the dermis, I am finding sheets of foamy macrophages. There are no appendages. I am not able to see the hair follicles and other things. And bacilli will be more in number. So I hope you people will be able to remember it. We shall be revising it because it is a university question. And there is something called the bacillary index. So bacillary index is depending on the load of the bacilli. It is given over here. You people can go through it. And accordingly, it can be from 1 plus to 6 plus. In 6 plus, there are more than 1,000 bacilli per field. Probably this is 5 or 6. I find that there are multiple bacilli that are found within the foamy macrophages, stained with the acid fast stain. The next one is the tuberculoid type of leprosy, which is posibacillary. Posibacillary means lower amount of bacilli. The immune status of the host is good. And the patient presents with irregular pale patches, which can be anesthetic or hypoesthetic. There will be a lower amount of sensation. What the dermatologist will be doing is, he asks the patients to turn around and then touches these areas with a wisp of cotton and also this, so that he is able to observe whether the patient is seeing the difference. So it can be a superficial sensation or a deep sensation that is examined for. It affects the face, the trunk, and the extremities. Here it is a case of the trunk. Nerves are particularly involved in a case of tuberculoid leprosy, so much so there can be a nerve abscess which can be formed. And the nerves commonly affected in the case of leprosy are the ulnar nerve, the posterior auricular nerve, and the peroneal nerve. One of the clinical diagnoses will be to look for thickening of the nerves. And because of the motor nerves being affected, there can be a muscular atrophy. So these are some of the features of tuberculoid leprosy. And microscopically see what we are finding out. Here, this is the epidermis, and these elongations are the retae ridges. They are unaffected. Lower down, I am finding the perineural and the periappendageal granulomata. Look at this particular lesion over here. Well circumscribed, I am able to see a few Langhans type of giant cells. The paler cells are the epithelioid cells, and the small dark cells are the lymphocytes. They are well circumscribed, lower down. That is why they will be perineural, periappendageal. They will destroy the nerves. They can destroy the sweat glands. There will be absence of sweating. This is a higher magnification of it. I hope you people are able to appreciate the pale cells over here. This is the cytoplasm and this is the nucleus. And these are all the epithelioid cells over here. Towards the periphery, I am finding a band-like cell or interwoven cells, which are the fibroblasts. And there are some dark cells called the lymphocytes. So these constitute a granuloma. The difference between tuberculosis and this is, here it is non-caseating. Non-caseating granuloma, dense cup of lymphocytes, perineural spread, nerve thickening can be there. Sometimes there can be a nerve abscess. I shall show you what it is. This I would like you people to describe. So what are you seeing in this? In this patient, I am finding a coarse facial feature. Coarse. It is very rough. It is bilaterally symmetrical. And there is a loss of eyebrows, loss of the eyelids. So obviously, the patient can be exposed to exposure keratitis. Sometimes because of the neural involvement, there can be a lid lag, which again can contribute to the exposure keratitis. Look at the ear lobes. They are thickening. Thickening of the ear lobes. Coarse faces, loss of the eyebrows, exposure keratitis. And sometimes there can be a collapse of the bridge of the nose, which I had shown in one of the earlier pictures, called the saddle nose deformity. Hopefully, we shall be seeing such a picture again. And all put together, what can we say? It resembles a lion. And then it is called a leonine facies. Look at this one. You find that there is a coarse feature, collapse of the bridge of the nose, and you find features are bilaterally symmetrical, etc. Very rough, and same features are seen, and hence it is called as leonine facies, a classical feature of lepromatous leprosy. And here again, all the other things I will not be mentioning. You can see that there is a saddle nose deformity because of the collapse. Saddle nose can occur in other conditions. In congenital syphilis also you can get because of the collapse of the omer or the bridge of the nose. So coming to lepromatous leprosy, it is a multibacillary. Tuberculoid is posibacillary. There are coarse faces, symmetrical, collapse of the bridge. Rhinorrhea, there can be a running nose, and the bacilli are located in the cooler part. This is one area where they will proliferate. Loss of the eyebrows are there, exposure keratitis, thickening of the nerves. Strangely, there will be a testicular atrophy also, because the bacilli can, this is one other area where it will thrive, the testis. It is lower down, and therefore the temperature is lower than the rest of the body. And there can be a destruction of the testosterone, and hence the patient can present with gynecomastia. So beautiful feature. Very well compiled. I would like you people to kindly read this. And this is a picture that you people can draw. So flattening of the epidermis, clear zone called the Gren zone or the unknown band of Anna, sheets of foamy macrophages. FM means foamy macrophages. And this is called the clear zone over here. Thinning out of the epidermis. That is what I mentioned as toe. Sheets are there, no granuloma, and the bacillary load is increased. It can be 5 or 6 in grading. And this is just a summary of all. I would like you people to memorize it, but this is not adequate if questions are asked. Tuberculoid can be a question by itself. Lepromatous is a question. Leprosy can be an essay question. Please do remember all this. And this is just a summary, a recollection. In this case, I want to highlight the foamy macrophages. Look at the cells. They are showing large vacuoles over here. Nucleus slightly pushed towards the periphery. And these are the foamy histiocytes or modified macrophages, which will be containing increased amount of bacilli. That can be demonstrated by means of some special stains. We shall see them. And here, thinning of the epidermis, clear zone, sheets of foamy macrophages. There is another condition called hypersensitivity reaction or immunology. There are two types of hypersensitivity. One is called the type 1, the other is type 2. In type 1, it is a delayed type of hypersensitivity. There can be either a progression of a disease or a regression of a disease. It usually occurs in borderline type of leprosy. And there may be necrosis or microabscess formation. Please by heart this one. And there is another reaction called erythema nodosum leprosum. This occurs in lepromatous leprosy on treatment. So there is a destruction of the bacilli. Immune complex deposition can be seen. The patient can also develop neuritis and nephritis because of the immune complexes. So this we had already shown. The granulomata. And in tuberculoid leprosy, as I mentioned earlier, there is an ulnar nerve that is thickened and they are draining out. It is almost like drainage of an abscess. Here, clear fluid is being collected, which can be rich in lepra bacilli. I would like you people to kindly recollect all this history and remember. Think of the subheadings will take you to the answer. Please recollect all these. And what are the investigations that can be done in leprosy? One is a slit skin smear, either from the earlobe or the finger. They make a smear out of it for the lepra bacilli and the cells. Lepromin test, it is a test done with the dead bacilli. This is important in pathology, the Wade-Veit-Farrakhan stain, which is a modified acid fast stain, which will stain the lepra bacilli. Bacterial index, we had mentioned earlier also. Morphological index is the amount of dead bacilli which are present. And the disadvantage, it cannot be grown in culture. However, some animals like the nine-banded armadillo will be showing similar features and has been used in laboratory study. I hope you are able to recollect this particular person. He is one called Father Damien, who had devoted his life in the treatment of leprosy patients and in serving them. And this gentleman, I hope you are able to identify also. He is the older version of Father Damien, and he himself developed the disease. And there have been many great people who have contributed. As I mentioned earlier, Hansen, Ridley and Joplin, they are the people who have contributed to multiple classifications of leprosy. And there is a great center called Karigiri. Karigiri Leprosy Center is over here. It is near Vellore. And you must remember that Chengalpet near Chennai is one of the centers that has got a great population for leprosy. Gracias.